Welcome everybody to this adventure meditation. First, I want to give you a little introduction. It's gonna be different than guided meditations you might have listened to before, which can be rather slow. So this one will be a bit faster paced. It's a journey, like a dream. You are on the move, and you will discover new or forgotten aspects of yourself and your spirit. During the meditation, you can sit or lay down. Close your eyes or keep them open. And if you feel like moving during the meditation, please feel free to do so. This journey will require you to use your imagination in many different ways, which is a very good thing, since our life, our planet, and even the whole universe are a product of the imagination. It is the divine spark in us that contains infinities. So use it, your wonderful human imagination, to fill in the blanks, to travel to this other world, embellish it to your liking, and make it come alive. And don't worry if you cannot connect during the first time with one aspect of the journey. I want to invite you to do it a couple of times, and things will open up for you, and your experience will get deeper and deeper. So here we go. You can close your eyes. And now you're floating effortlessly above a white temple of knowledge. The temple stands atop four huge round pillars, which hold the temple up over a calm ocean of pink water. One pillar is made of pure gold. Another one is made of silver. The third is one of ruby. And the last one is whatever you want it to be. You think how much you want to go over there. And the next moment, you hail over a cab made of clouds. The driver is a yellow lightning bolt. To welcome you, he shoots bolts of very pleasant energy into you. The energy makes you tingle like a silent smile, and it bathes you in a sense of readiness for the adventure. Feel the readiness. Feel confidence swell your chest. The cab then moves you over to the pillars, coming to a halt in front of the golden one. You reach out with your hand, feeling its warmth. The gold energy flows into your body, leaving a golden dust around your organs, bones, and every one of your muscles it touches. Breathe, inhale, and exhale. And do it again. And with every inhale, you intensify the feeling of the golden energy flowing within you. It awakens glory, your glory, like a symphony orchestra of grand emotions playing within you. There are violins plucking your heartstrings, making it sing. And now, you shift the dynamics, and via the palm of your hand, you send your own unique personal energy and your favorite emotion into the golden beam. And as you do that, you see your energy moving up the golden beam and to the place at which it connects with the temple. And you feel how the temple is being nourished by your energy, and how it becomes more of the essence of what it really is. and you get excited and confident in your own power, and you send more and more energy into the goal and up into the temple. Yeah, intensify the energy, make it more alive. You're a creator, you can do whatever you want, and this is a magical feeling. Breathe in and breathe out. Bathe yourself in this magical feeling of being a creator. And breathe it in and out. And then, without the cap and just by your own power, you levitate up towards the entrance of the temple. Feel the levitation. The entrance is made up of two horses standing on the hind legs and forming a gate with their touching front legs. You pass through the gate, and behind it awaits your very friendly guide, who is a pipe-smoking alien in whatever form you wish him or her to be. Imagine, create your own alien, the shape of the eyes, the height, the color. Just see what comes up in your mind's eye. The two of you then greet each other via telepathy. And as you notice an invisible beam of energy, which is an emanation from his mind, touch you, you instantaneously relax completely. Because this invisible beam of energy acts like a massage for your mind. The two of you walk through the temple together. And you can ask the alien any question you would like to ask him. And he answers the question by taking a puff from his pipe and blowing out smoke that forms into a visual answer just for you. And you do this for a while. And then you turn around one more corner and you enter a room filled with several monks from different religions. The monks are engaged in making a sand mandala. They're co-creating. And you gaze for a while at the happenings, and then you take up the brush, so to speak, and start adding colored sand to the mandala. This goes on for a while. And you notice how the mandala becomes more alive. You detect a breathing motion flowing through the mandala, and it even seems there's a manifest mood and attitude in it. And then the mandala starts to vibrate faster and faster. And it rises off the ground and turns itself into a three-dimensional object. After looking at it for a while, you realize it is a stargate, a door to another dimension. Whilst looking into it, you see something vague, something unclear. You feel an urge to go, a really strong urge for adventure, the unknown. And the silent voice of concern, a fear of going too far, somewhere distant in the back of your mind, fades away as you gaze more and more spellbound into the stargate. And within you rises an unknown feeling, and you realize that what you are about to do is bigger than the steps the first guy on the moon took. Breathe. Feel that feeling. And you then close your imaginary eyes and you walk calmly through the Stargate. As you pass it, a cool shiver runs over your skin. The next moment, your whole body becomes really light, freed from the pull of gravity. You open your eyes again, and you find yourself surrounded by water. You feel the water gently pressing against you, against your whole front, your face and chest, against your whole back and neck, and also against your sides. The pressure makes you really come alive and feel good. You orient yourself in this new scene, and you're now in front of a sunken city on the ground of an ocean. Sunken ships from different epochs rest silently around the city. Schools of yellow and red fish swim through the streets of plankton that run between huge seashells, which resemble houses. Next to one of these shelters, you spot your friend, the pipe-smoking alien again, who is talking to an octopus. You're glad that he's here with you. Then slowly gathers a group of mermaids around you. They move so gracefully, with so much radiance, through the water. And as a big red crab, with an even bigger smile, takes up the spot in the center as their conductor, you know you are surrounded by an underwater choir. The mermaids start singing towards you, and you're suddenly in the middle of water bubbles, which, as they burst next to you, reveal their personal sounds. It is music like you've never heard it before. Hear it. The music brings you into a high ecstasy, and the alien, on top of all that, dances with abandon between the singers and you, puffing out grandiose colors and shapes from his pipe, in tune with the music. You feel your blood, your life juice, streaming throughout the many, many pathways of your body. And while you feel the blood streaming, you then make the drops that make up your blood. You make them dance and whirl with the music. And now, open portals from the mermaids' solar plexuses, and they radiate from these portals beams of color towards you. Each mermaid sends her own color, and the rays simultaneously enter your heart and fill it up with the different colors and energies. Feel them. Breathe it in and breathe it out. And breathe it in and breathe out. And your heart then takes these colors and pulses them throughout your body. And the colors and the energies dance. They dance together within you, whilst the alien keeps on dancing with abandon, and the red crab conducts the mermaidian choir into higher and higher brilliance of expression. And you just sit with that all for a while, in silence. You might want to reflect on what element stood out in this journey for you. Give it a second thought, because it could be a golden thread for you, leading you down a magical road, if you have the courage and trust to stick with it for a while. And also I want to urge you again to listen to this meditation a number of times, because with every time the experience will get deeper, new areas and spaces will open up for you. You will have new insights, new understandings. And if you want to work with me or receive my newsletter, check out the description of this video for more information. And now on a final note, I want you to consider the mood and energy you are now in and ask yourself, what do I want to do coming from that place? What do I want to create with that feeling, that energy? Whatever it is, I want to again thank you for listening and wish you all the best. Ciao.